mini deep dish pizzas that are super easy to make, a delicious homemade hoagie, and a meat-free lunch with a twist on the classic PB&J. These lunch ideas and more are coming your way. I'm Jennifer with the Family Fudge, and welcome to Subscriber Lunch Sunday. On this channel, I really love to share lunch ideas for all ages, but in today's video, I'm making lunches with teens in mind specifically, although these lunches will definitely work for other age groups as well. The lunch ideas I'm making today were sent to me by a few awesome members of my Bunches of Lunches Facebook group. So if you're looking for a community where you can share your own lunch creations, or if you're looking for a place to get lots and lots of lunch inspiration, this is definitely the group for you. And you guys, I'll go ahead and add a link to the Facebook group in the description box below if you'd like to check it out. Now you guys, I received so many awesome lunch ideas for teens in the Facebook group, and if I could, I would make every single one of those lunches. But today I'm just focusing on four, and the first one was sent in by Shelly. And her lunch idea definitely caught my eye because the main course is pizza, and I know a lot of teens specifically love pizza. Now I know there are so many different types and ways that you can make pizza, but for today's lunch, Shelly requested some pizza muffins. So for these pizzas, I'm going to be using one can of biscuit dough, a little bit of tomato sauce, some shredded mozzarella cheese, and I'm also using these mini pepperonis. Now, of course, you could also use any other kind of pizza topping that you prefer, but today I'm keeping things nice and simple. So I've already started by preheating my oven at 350 degrees. Next, I'm going to take my muffin pan, and I am gonna go ahead and pop in some of my silicone liners. This makes cleanup so easy, and it really helps whatever I'm cooking not to stick to my pan. If you don't have these, no problem. You just gotta make sure to grease your muffin pan really well. Next, I'm going to take one biscuit and I'm going to press it into the cavity of each little muffin cup. Now, if your biscuits are really big, you might wanna go ahead and cut them in half because you don't want this to be overflowing with dough. You wanna make sure to have enough space for your toppings. Now, as you can see, I've created a little cavity in the center, and in here, I'm just gonna add a little bit of sauce followed by the mozzarella cheese. And then of course those mini pepperonis. I really like the mini ones for this. I think they are super cute, but regular sized pepperonis would also work. Now to fancy these up just a little bit, I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle some Italian seasoning right on the top before I pop these into the oven. Now you guys, these cook pretty quickly, just about 12 minutes or so. And of course you could serve these nice and hot, but they're also good at room temperature, which makes them perfect for throwing into a lunch. You could even make a big batch of these and freeze them. That way you could just pull out a couple at a time to throw into lunches. So now that the main course is done, I'm going to move on to Shelly's fruit. Today she picked out grapes, so I'm just going to fill this entire container with as many as I can fit. And then for the vegetable, I'm going to add a combination of carrots and celery. For the carrots, I'm just using baby carrots, so it's nice and easy, no chopping involved. And for the celery, I've just cut them to be about the same size as the carrot. Now, of course, to go along with the carrots and the celery, I'm also adding a small container of ranch. And since I'm making these lunches with teens in mind, I'm not gonna be adding in a cute little sauce container. I'm just gonna add in a regular one. And in this section, I've made sure to keep enough space for a little snack to go in here as well. For Shelly's lunch, she requested some pizza Pringles, so I'll go ahead and put them right in here. And then you guys, for the sweet treat, something that I haven't had in a long time, these are the Little Debbie oatmeal cookie sandwiches. Now I think these are really good, but you guys will have to let me know in the comments down below if you've ever tried them. Honestly, every time I see these, I can't help but think of the movie Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. Let me know if you know what I'm talking about. And then finally, to complete this lunch, I'm just gonna be adding in a big bottle of water to go along with it. Next up, I'm going to be making Casey's lunch. And for her main course, she requested a turkey club sandwich. And instead of just making this on a regular bread, I thought it would be a little bit different. to make it on a sandwich roll instead. I don't often do that, but it sounds really good. Now, I'm calling this a hoagie, but I guess you could also call it a sub sandwich. Honestly, I'm not really sure what the difference is in those names. All I know is that it's gonna be delicious. So for this hoagie, I'm going to start by very carefully opening up the bread. I'm really hoping that this bread will stay together and not separate all the way through. Now, as you can see, I'm building this sandwich on top of a parchment paper that is on top of a cookie sheet. And that's because I'm actually going to toast this sandwich. So the first thing I'm going to add on to here is the turkey. I'm gonna be adding several slices. Next, I'm gonna be adding in some cheese. Now, I know not all club sandwiches include cheese, but I thought I'd go ahead and add some anyway because I love cheese. And I went ahead and cut the cheese into triangle shapes because that's what they do at Subway. Next, I'm going to add several slices of bacon. Now, this is the pre-cooked bacon. You guys know I love taking that shortcut. And now at this point, I'm going to stick the entire thing into the oven for just a few minutes. I'm really going to keep my eye on this because I do not want to burn the bread. So now that this is nicely toasted, I can go ahead and pick up the sandwich off of the cookie sheet and I can add the rest of the ingredients. At this point, I'm gonna go ahead and squirt on a little bit of mayo and a little bit of mustard. Next, I'm going to add some thinly sliced tomatoes. Now, if you're not a big fan of tomatoes, you could definitely leave this out. You don't have to have them. Then on top of the tomatoes, I'm gonna add a good amount of shredded iceberg lettuce. This is nice and crisp and fresh, and it's so good in this sandwich. Now, at this point, I'm just gonna be shaking on a little bit of salt and pepper. If you wanted to, you could also add oil and vinegar or other spices. So now I'm going to carefully close this up and get it into the lunchbox. And doesn't that look delicious? So now that that's done, I'm going to move on to the fruit. And for Casey's lunch, she asked for a fruit salad. So this is actually a combination of strawberries, blueberries, and grapes. I'm gonna go ahead and fill this entire section with as much as I can. And then for her vegetables, she requested carrots. So I'm just gonna be adding in some of these crinkle cut carrots with just a little container of ranch on the side for dipping. For Casey's snack, she requested yogurt. So this is just a good old plain vanilla Greek yogurt with a strawberry on top for good measure. And then for her treat, she requested a trail mix granola bar. So I decided to grab these ones. These look pretty good. And then last but not least, for her drink, she requested a lemon or lime flavored water. I actually have both options, but I'm gonna go ahead and add the lemon flavored water. This next lunch idea is completely meat-free, and it was sent in by Kaylin. And you guys, this is the one that has the twist on a PB&J that I was telling you about. Instead of using bread for Kaylin's lunch, I'm gonna be using two of these rice cakes. Now, if your lunchbox won't fit a huge rice cake, you could always cut these or break them in half. And these are actually the plain rice cakes. These are just lightly salted. They don't have any sugar or anything like that on them. And then, of course, to go along with them, I'm also gonna be adding in a little bit of peanut butter. This is just a good old natural peanut butter. And then for the jelly, I thought it would be really good to use some of this mango flavored jelly. This is really good, especially if you're a huge mango fan. And as you can see, I've put the peanut butter and the jelly in separate containers. So the idea is that at lunchtime, you would actually be able to spread it on the rice cake at that point. For Kaylin's fruit, she requested raspberries. So I'm just gonna fill up this section right here. And for her vegetable, I'm actually doing a combination of cucumbers and tomatoes, but she also requested I shake a little bit of the everything but the bagel seasoning right on top. And you know, I've never tried this, but it sounds so good. Of course, this seasoning has a little bit of garlic and onion, salt and pepper and sesame seeds. It is really good. Next, for Kaylin's snack, she requested some banana muffins. So I decided to go with these pre-made ones from the store. I know a lot of high schoolers or teenagers in general are going for quick and easy lunches. So having these already made ones are super convenient. And then for her treat, she requested some fruit leathers. And I decided to go with the raspberry flavored one. And then finally, to complete Kaylin's lunch, I'm just going to be adding in some fruit-flavored water. Okay guys, now that brings me to a lunch idea sent in by Alexandra. And for her main course, she requested something called crescent sausage bites. Now actually, these would be really good for breakfast or lunch. You could serve them hot or at room temperature. For this recipe, I'm using 1 pound of sausage. This is already cooked and drained. I'm using turkey sausage, but you can use whatever kind you want. I'm also going to be using 1 package of cream cheese and 2 packages of crescent dough. Now, I really like the crescent sheets because I think it's a lot easier, but you could also use the regular crescent dough. You'll just need to pinch together the seams so that you have one big sheet of dough. So in a separate bowl, I'm going to combine the room temperature cream cheese with the sausage, and I'm just going to mix the two together. Now, I'm going to go ahead and set that aside and grab my baking sheet. And I am going to go ahead and put down a little piece of parchment paper just to make it a little bit easier to clean up when I'm done. I've preheated my oven at 375 degrees, and now I'm ready to open up my first package of dough, and I'm really just going to roll this out, and it's going to stay in this rectangle shape. Next, I'm going to take the cream cheese and sausage mixture, and I'm going to spread it as evenly as I can all over the dough, but I'm not actually taking the mixture all the way to the edges. I'm making sure to leave a little bit of the edges out. Now I'm going to very carefully open up my second package of dough, and I'm going to try my best to get this on top as evenly as I can. No worries if it's not completely straight, it'll be totally fine. So now I'm going to go ahead and take a fork, and I'm going to just kind of crimp the edges together a bit, and now it's ready to cook. Now if you wanted to, you could also add a little bit of an egg wash on top of here. That would definitely help give it a lot of color. But today I'm just keeping it simple, and I'm going to cook it in the oven for about 15 to 20 minutes. Now once this is out of the oven and it's had a little bit of time to cool down, you can go ahead and cut it into little squares. I'm going to go ahead and add these squares into the lunchbox, and then I can move on to the fruit. On this side, I'm going to add some strawberries that I've cut into hearts, and over on this side, I'm adding some pineapple chunks. For Alexandra's vegetables, she requested some sugar snap peas, so I did go ahead and trim the edges off of them. And then to go along with these, I'm also adding in a container of ranch to this section. And then over in the front section of this lunchbox, I'm going to be adding in some veggie straws. These are a delicious snack. And then for her treat, she requested yogurt. And you guys, I recently saw these new yogurt tubes at Target. I'm not sure if they're good or not, but we're going to give them a try. And then the very last thing I'm adding into Alexandra's lunch is just some water. Now let me know in the comments down below, out of all of these lunches today, which one is your favorite? Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.